We're here at Redondo Beach looking for the Pacific spiny lumpsucker, the deadliest fish ever. This legendary monster is so deadly that it's literally covered in teeth. If you got into a fight with this fish, you would have to run away because it can't. A pack of these vicious wild animals, once they smell blood, can skeletonize a cow in whoa!
So usually when people dive Redondo, they start out here, between the fishing pier and the aquarium. The bottom slopes pretty quickly down to 80 to 90 feet, and you can find fun bottom features like sunken boats and human remains, Halloween decorations there. Today though, we're going to Lumpy Land. This is an area just to the south where the bottom slopes much more gently, and we can look for smaller critters like the aforementioned spiny lumpsucker, hence the name. For this dive, we didn't even break 20 feet. First, we surface swim out to the end of the boat launch. And then descend on one of the pilings there. So lumpsuckers are actually about as far away from deadly as you can get. But the thing about being covered in teeth is true. More on that in a bit. The reason we're diving in this area is that we're looking for smaller critters. They like to stay shallow here because of the eelgrass, which thrives at depths of 10 to 20 feet. Small fish and invertebrates can hide in the abundant grassy leaves and stay safe from bigger predators. But small stuff doesn't make up the entirety of the life in the shallows. Ariel points out a red rock crab munching on a moon snail. Mollusk. Lewis's moon snails are the largest of the moon snails. Their shells can grow up to 5.5 inches across. Of course, after seeing that crab chowing down, your first thought is, "Save some for me!" Wait, what? It's not? Well, it was the first thing on Ariel's mind, at least. Soon, we come upon a hooded nudibranch. These critters are actually related to the slugs in your garden. Unlike those slugs, though, they have a big fringed hood that they use to collect plankton to eat. They love eelgrass and kelp because they can climb up on the blades and collect food in the current. We saw a ton of other nudibranchs, like this, red-gilled nudibranch? Honestly, there's a bunch of different species that look like this, and I can't tell the difference, so I'm just gonna call it Bob. Hi, Bob. Finally, we came upon a lumpsucker. Alright, I promised to talk about the teeth things, so I will. See all those little spiky things the lumpy is covered in? Those aren't scales, they're actually called dermal denticles. As the etymology geeks have already figured out, that basically means skin teeth. As you can see, lumpies don't swim particularly well. The skin teeth thing is kind of related to this. Denticles are lighter and stronger than scales, and since lumpies live in the intertidal zone where they get smacked around by currents and rocks, they need as much armor as they can possibly get. The downside to this is that these skin teeth can't really be repaired. The University of Washington's Friday Harbor Labs has found that 100% of older lumpsuckers show damage to their denticles. But of course, how can I not talk about their name? Lumpsucker comes from the Latin word lumpius suckeratoni and, no it doesn't. They are lumps, and their pelvic fins have fused into a sucker that they use to cling to rocks and kelp. Hence, lumpsucker. Hey, at least they didn't get named by the guy who named the bony-eared ass fish. Go on, look it up. It's real. Finally, Ariel signals me to point something out. It's this moon snail, right? It does look tasty, doesn't it? Yum yum. Wait a minute, you're pointing to something else, aren't you? What is it? Oh my god, it's an adorable little octo. This could be a baby red octopus, or it could be a giant Pacific octopus. They both look pretty similar at this size. And yes, giant Pacific octopus, which can grow to have an arm span of 14 feet, and normal-sized red octopus, which can achieve an arm span of just under 2 entire feet, both start out super tiny. Well, it's time to take a cue from this octo and GT bleep O. Our dive lasted about 95 minutes.